respected mutton chops, fishy face kipper slapper, and a whole load of creamy muck muck, because of course it's Dick and Dom in the bungalow. And I think the safest place for me is on the CBBC channel. I'll see you over there this afternoon. Good luck.
Seen the time, the kids were all here at 8:40, so don't be surprised if you hear them shout. Okay, your trousers all inside out. Go, go, Dick and Dom. Go, go, Dick and Dom. Go, go, Dick and Dom.
Come on.
All right, lovely.
And now, before you can do and say this,
wiggity wiggity wah!
Let's meet the bungalow heads! The bungalow heads are back for another big bungalow game. Come on in, our first bungalow head. Morning!
It's still snowing. Snow's in, but how are you?
Still snow.
Hello, I'm all right.
You're all right, what's your name?
Roger.
Who?
Roger.
Roger, lovely to meet you. And what is, how old are you, by the way?
Nine.
A healthy 9-year-old person.
And what have you brought with us? What treats have you got in that box?
A present.
What present? What is it?
What is it?
It's Indian sweets.
Indian sweets? Oh, can we rip them open and have a look? Are they nice? What are they? Oh.
I got given some of these on Diwali.
Smell good. Smell good.
I got someone given some of these.
Do too many raisins.
Is it Diwali? Okay, right, take off your bag. Oh, thank you very much. Let's put that gently over here.
Well, thank you for that, Roger. He's making himself at home. He's most welcome.
I'm finished with you here. Come on,
no, let's go
Roger.
And sit down with him over here. If you want to sit down, you can sit down,
we'll
Roger.
We'll all put our feet up with you.
Now, Roger, when you were little, you used to take your clothes off and drive around in a little toy truck.
Well,
is that true?
Well, we've actually got a picture of you driving your toy truck with the clothes
on. I've got it over here. It's here, look. It's here. Here it is. There it is. There's the picture of you. With your clothes off. So this morning, Raja, we want to recreate the moment. But we don't want you to take your clothes off.
And we don't have a toy truck.
So recreate the moment.
Go stand there and do that.
What you did when you did.
Brilliant.
Leaving his clothes off. Right.
There you go. Thank you very much, Raja. Cheers. You're welcome. Welcome.
Hey, hello.
And what's your name, young sir?
Dilby.
Who?
Dilby.
Lovely to meet you.
Dilby.
How are you?
All right.
And this is your bungalow. This is your bungalow for the whole weekend.
Dilby, who's your mate?
Dilly Mindy.
It's what?
Don't worry about the name, but shall I play it?
Oh, well, no, what's his name? What should we call him?
Think of a name for him.
Call him Mindy.
Mindy.
Mandy.
Okay. Mindy. Here's Mandy.
This is Mandy. He rocks.
But
What?
You're supposed to do that if
I'll
you don't
do it again.
No, you're supposed to do that if you don't dance.
He bends over and starts singing.
Yeah.
Is he doing the butt dance?
Yeah.
Mandy's doing the butt dance on the
bungalow. Silly old Mandy.
Now, Dilbert, I've heard that you like to jump around and do an impression of Sean Connery.
Yeah.
So can you do both at the same time, do you reckon?
Yeah, first of all, take off your coat, we'll get your bag.
Welcome.
We'll get your glossy bag. What's in there, please? It's
nice.
Lovely,
right.
Thank you very much. Oh, there you are.
Staying the night, the whole weekend in the bungalow. And Bill Beard, now there's your stage. Jump up and down and do an impression of Sean Connery.
Hello, Dick and Dom. I can do a Scottish accent.
Go on then, do the Scottish accent.
Hello. Hey. What do you want me for? Hello, Dick and Dom.
Now, Dilbert,
you jumped up and down, that's great, but where was the impression of Sean Connery?
I can, but I can't do it.
Okay, well, we'll do them separately, okay? Do the impression of Sean Connery, facing that, because everyone wants to see you.
Hello, Dick and Dom. My name's Dua Bichaka. I come from Southall and I go to North Primary School.
No, Sean Connery. Oh, Sean Connery, are you all right? Are you a bit flushed?
No.
Is it all a bit embarrassing being it? Go on, go on, do your Sean Connery impression.
I can't do
You can't do a Sean Connery.
I'm Scottish.
I tell you what, Dilber, just to, for safety's sake, do you want just a biscuit and a beaker of fizzy pop? There you are. Thank you very much. Dilber, welcome to the Bungalow. Who's next? We're going to be crazy.
It's Daniela.
Hello, Daniela. How are you?
Hello, Daniela.
Hey, you like this? Look at this. Very nice indeed. Come on in, Daniela. How old are you, Daniela?
9 years old.
And how do you know the rest of the Bungalow heads?
We go to the same school.
You all go to the same school? Yeah. How nice. Oh, you brought us a present too. What is it?
It's Indian sweets.
More Indian sweets?
More Indian. I'm enjoying these Indian sweets.
It is, then.
If I can get in them, then I'll have one.
Go on. All right, then. Now it says here, Daniela, that you're 9 years old, and where do you come from? You come down the road
from
Provence of All right, then. Well, that says here that you can skip and do the 12 times table backwards.
I got my skipping rope on me, so I can just do the 12.
You haven't got the skipping rope on you. Well, in that case, just skip. Like this.
Kind of a skip.
Like this. Skip and do the 12 times table backwards.
Go on. Go on, you two boys. Skip.
Ready? Go on.
Skip behind you.
12 times 12 is 144. 11 times 12 is 132. 10 times 12 is 120.
Everyone having fun? Everyone enjoy it?
This, ladies and gentlemen, is a talent she's got here, Daniela. She got skip and do the 12 times
table. Do that thing again. Do that thing again.
All right, I'll do that thing again. Makes a funny noise, Daniela. Welcome.
It's a very flashback, isn't it?
Very flash. Thank you, Daniela. Thank you. Who's next?
Hello, little man.
Hello, you.
It's Remandy.
It's a little man.
Hello. Oh, by the way, come back here, Gilbert. You did something earlier, what? And our spies found out.
Yes.
And you can say hello, Dick and Dom, in a very strange way. Go on then.
Hello, Dick and Dom.
Do it again. Come over here.
Hello, Dick and Dom.
I'm liking that. 10 bucks.
Terrifying.
First one, Dilbert. The game has begun. Hello, Ramandeep. How are you?
Fine.
Good. Welcome to our bungalow. When you were younger, you snuck into your mum's bedroom and covered her face in lipstick.
Oh!
How did she feel about that?
Fine.
Not very happy. We've got some lipstick somewhere. Where is it, Dom? Find the lipstick.
It's over there.
There. Right, can you show us what you did on yourself?
Go on. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, very good.
Right, now. Very good. Now, Ramandeep, pretend Dom's your mum. Pretend Dom's your mum. There you are. This is what he did to his mum.
Nice.
Oh, actually, Dom, you look a bit like Ramandeep's mum.
Ooh.
How nice. Ramandeep, thank you. I'm going to give you 15 bungalow points for doing that.
Thank you very much.
Who's next? Come on in. Oh, it's tall. It's a tall man.
It's a tall man. Howdy do.
All right.
What's your name?
Colin.
Who?
Colin.
Colin. Hello. We're going to relieve you.
Relieve you
of your bag.
And your
coat. Yeah.
Now, let me take and relieve you of your coat. And relieve you of your present. What is this? Is it for us?
No.
Yes, no.
Yes,
it is?
Yes.
Well, is it or isn't it?
It is.
Let me guess. Let me guess what it is. What? Indian sweets.
No.
It's, what is it
it's
then?
Bread.
Yeah!
I'll tell you what, you lot know how to wrap your presents.
It's
well,
bread
don't
and
you?
It says BBC.
It's what?
It says BBC.
Yeah,
look. What is it?
It is BBC. Look at this!
This is quick!
Unwrap it!
Put it into the right order. BBC.
Quick!
CBB. No, that's not it. BBC. There you are.
It's BBC bread! Welcome to the BBC television service. It's the BBC Bread Corporation.
Lovely! Thank you very much, Kevin.
Don't throw it. We'll put it in the kitchen. Have it later.
We'll have it later. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Finally this morning on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow, our final bungalow bed. What's your name?
Tanya.
I don't know.
Well, why, how come you don't know? You bought it for us. It's a present.
Tanya.
Why do you think we would like some naan bread?
Enough about the naan bread, Tanya. How old are you, my dear?
Oh, 10.
Oh, 10. Oh, 10.
Two 10.
Oh, 10.
That's 2 10. That's 20.
Oh, 10. Oh, 10.
Oh, 10. Oh, 10.
Come on.
Oh,
say your age. Oh, 10.
Oh, 10. Oh, 10.
Right. Tanya, you're a famous burper.
Yeah.
Would you like to...
Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah,
would you like to say burp the alphabet for us for some bungalow points?
Yeah.
Up to Z.
Yeah.
Yeah, why not?
We'll get bungalow points.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, no, she's going
to get... Do you want some pop just to start it off? That'll get the
move. Down.
Right, go for it.
A, B, actually, maybe get to E. 28.
Yes!
Thank you very much, Danny. 21 points. Well done.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Ooh, you did get
Heads are here to earn Bungalow points. Bungalow points mean prizes. Do you want to see the prizes we've got for you this weekend?
Yeah.
Oh, they're lovely. Third prize is that. That's it. It's just
what that.
Anyone want that?
No.
All right, then. Okay. Well. Good job. We've got a really good second prize.
It's like a school assembly today, isn't it?
Yeah.
Anyone want that?
No.
All right, then. We've got a good second prize for you. Here we go. Have a look at this. This is what you get. Come second in the Bungalow. It's a colour television. It'd be a bit poor if it was black and white.
But it's a DVD combi, mate, with DVDs.
Who wants a DVD combi with DVDs? Hey, you can put it in your bedroom, Jack. Yeah. All right, well, even better, we've got a numero uno prize, a number one prize. Here it is.
Oh, my God!
Stick your thumbs up.
It's
a PS2. Who wants the PS2?
Me!
One that's actually got a lid that lifts up so you can use it as a portable one and use it on your TV.
Yeah!
The special bonus prize is back. The leader of today's Bungalow at 11 o'clock will get a special bonus prize, which is a CD player!
And CDs! What did you just do? Oh.
Lovely. Now we want you to fill in the missing words. Have you seen this before? Yes?
Blank, fill in the missing words, we'll come back in a bit.
If they're any good, we'll give you some Bungalow points. Remember now, don't be rudy. You at home can get involved in the Bungalow this morning if you'd like to call in on
us. Here he is, it's the next door neighbour.
Oh, yes. Idiot.
Hi, how are you?
Good, bad, and ugly. Yes.
Now, do us a favour, can you answer this question? What traditionally does Cub Scouts use marshmallows for?
Or be a loaf of bread.
A loaf of bread. That's exactly what Cub Scouts use marshmallows for.
If you want to win this, 090-1-900-500, that's Richard Dark Happy. Play, we'll call it something new today, I've decided.
Hey?
We're calling it Cod's Wallop.
Yes, Cod's Wallop, because Cod Wallop. But unfortunately, we still got a mackerel. So it's mackerel wallop. If you'd like to play mackerel wallop.
If you want to win that.
Lovely. Yes. Right, and what is that?
That is a bag of frozen peas.
A bag of frozen peas.
Right, okay.
That's a bag of frozen
peas. Do not laugh or you will lose. Digital teeny weeny.
What is this? That was frozen peas. What is that? What is this thing here?
It's a hammer.
It's a hammer! You can win the hammer for Do Not Laugh or You Will Lose. Phone in, think of a funny story that will make one of our Bungalow heads, or me and Dom, laugh. Call in on the
He really
button.
Is a prize idiot.
Prize!
Oh, yes. Hello.
Bye. Hello. He's such an idiot, isn't he?
And to get on Bungalow heads, have you finished?
Oh, no, we haven't finished. Wait, come back over here.
Do the emails. They're nearly finished.
Come over here. Come on. Look at all these. We got 5 email prizes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What are they? I hear you ask. Well, I'll tell you, I don't know. I think you spin them like this.
Yeah,
but it says press play.
Spin to win.
Wait. It does that.
Look.
It says something on top. It says last 3.
Nice. Bungalow@weebies.co.uk. Send in your funny emails now. 5 of them.
We've got 5.
Have you finished this time, Bungalow heads? Yes. Right. Let's have a look what you filled
in. Bungalow heads.
In the missing blanks. Why do fools fall in poo?
Hey! Excellent, very good, all right.
Chitty Chitty Bum Bum.
We like Chitty Chitty Bum Bum. Well done, have 18 Bungalow points each. 18 for that.
Fairly Hairy Dim Bim. Someone explain Dim Bim.
What is Dim Bim?
What's Dim Bim, Roger?
I have no idea.
You know, Stinky Feet makes the world go round. Liking it. Ring a Ring of Roses, a pocket full of Pong. It's Pong. It's definitely Pong, oh yes. Izzy Wizzy, let's get smelly. I like that one, Dilbert. Okay, 20 Bungalow points for Dilbert because he did that. Come here,
because now I'm going to show you what you can expect to see on the Bungalow today.
With those lips. This is what's on digging up in the Bungalow until 11 o'clock. The Maddest Town is back with Inspector Morton Shot. He'll be here.
Yeah, thank you very much. We've also got Yvonne of the UK.
Lovely, Yvonne. Do not laugh or you lose. Get calling in for that with your funny stories and win a digital camera.
Wow, we've got Bogey!
I'm still winning at the moment. Thank you so much. And Creamy Muckmuck with a special Star Wars feel to it today. Stay tuned.
But we don't know that. But that might actually be a surprise later for us, so we don't know that at all. Well done, Uri Geller.
Not surprised.
It's not a new game, but it's still great.
That's the name of the game. It's your legs, your head, if it's cold around your brain. Once your face is nice and hairy, it'll be a big relief. And as a grand finale, add a set of goofy teeth.
Did it, did it, did it, did it, did it. hairy fizzles. All you have to do, you've got 45 seconds on the clock. All team, bungalow heads, to get as much of this dirty Norris, smear it all over your face, then smear it all over your head, and then get all this hair here and stick it to your face and to your head, and then finish it off by getting some goopy teeth and sticking them in. The one with the most hair on their face and their head will be the winner of
150 bungalow points.
But, dicky-doo-dah, this hair has come from someone. Who has this hair come from today?
This hair. Who has this hair come from today?
Hey?
It's been donated. Yes. From Anna Moon.
Nana!
Don't ask me questions I can't answer. Nana Moon! Oh. Nana Moon's had her hair off, and there it is in these buckets. Oh. Right, remember to stick the goofy teeth in the last 5 seconds, bungalows, to win the points. Your time starts now.
Go! Come on. No, get your chocolate on your head first. Chocolate everywhere.
Chocolate everywhere.
Smear it all over your head and all over your face.
And then the hair and then the teeth. It's as simple as that.
Very hairy bits off.
Very hairy bits off. Come on, stick it all on.
Come on, that's it.
On.
Come on, no, all over your face. On your face. Get that chocolate on your face. Otherwise, you lose all your bungalow points. Even though you haven't really got any. Go on, just do it.
Stick some more hair on as well. That's it.
You now, Dilbert, you've got the idea.
He's got the idea on the end here. That's it, Dilbert. Loads of chocolate, then the
come
hair.
Come on.
Liking
you
it.
Could get loads of nice points.
Come on, 150 bungalow points are at stake.
Five, four,
get your teeth in.
Three, two, one.
Zorro.
Stop!
Dilbert got them in right at the end. Liking it, Dilbert? Look at that. Look at
put
it.
Put your teeth
look
in if it. You haven't got them in.
Dilbert, how are you feeling about all that? I'm liking all this kind of bit over here, yeah?
What?
You're not happy with it? Oh, you are happy with it. Yeah. He's happy. Nice.
Lipstick and
right.
Chocolate.
Ram and deep. Do you want to stick a bit more on? Go on then, I'll allow you. There you are, stick a little bit more. Lovely. The game is over. This won't count, but it'll look funny. There we are. Nice. All over your hands as well. Lovely.
Not Tanya's got the idea. Look at Tanya.
Tanya had the idea there. Yes, she got it all over her face. Look at that's a proper monster, isn't it? Monster in disguise. Thank you, Tanya. Nice.
Okay, moving on here to Daniela. Daniela, now I've got the kind of feeling that you're going to be one of those bungalow heads that doesn't really like getting that messy. Am I correct? It's the way you've delicately placed it on your bald head, not got any on your face. Daniela, look. Come on, get in the spirit. Just a little bit.
No.
Just a soup song.
She's not having it, mate.
All right, forget it. All right, Daniela, unlucky. Look at that. Just look. You've got a hairy head, none on your face. Over here. Well, got
what's that all about then?
Nothing really, but you look like you've had a really good time anyway.
Tanya, you're the winner of 150 bungalow points.
Well,
nice one. Here, bungalow head. The magic video cassette is back. Come on over here.
Everyone go sit down. Take your seats.
Here it is.
Oh, it's hot.
Hot off the press. There you
Everyone sit down. All right now. Bungalow heads, this is the videotape of magic. If you are watching on BBC One right now, and when I put this in, the video will play Scooby Dooby 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 Doo. However, if you're watching on the CBBC digital channel, capable abilities, then this videotape will play Tazza Tasmania. Yes, we broadcast to the nation. It's delightful.
It's your choice. You choose. See you in 10 minutes. Bye. CBBC, well, it can only mean one thing. It's Dig Dom and the Bungalow Head!
Yay! Yeah. Oh, do you want to enjoy your magic video? What did you watch? Did you watch Tazzy? What watch Scooby-Doo? Have you enjoyed it?
Codswallop.
What?
Codswallop.
All right, fair enough. Same to you.
No, it's the new game. It's not called Fish Face Kipper Slapper anymore. It's called Codswallop.
Yeah.
Because you can wallop your face with a cod.
Because Fish Face Kipper Slapper is stupid, isn't it?
Fish.
Did you just say fish?
No, I think you'll find it was you that said fish.
Ah, right.
Enough. All right, yes, cod wallop. You can slap your face round with a wallop your face.
With a cod.
Mackerel. Right then, let's find out who's going to be slapping themselves round the face with a mackerel today. Here they are. This is the person that's going to be doing it. The member of the public we have picked is called...
Andreas Sadler.
Their age is...
22.
Hometown...
Stockholm, Sweden.
Noise thing done.
Walking my dormitory by playing
the
hockey.
The most embarrassing
slapping time. Myself on the face on the telly.
I beg your pardon. And motto...
There's no so still stupid as you're stupid people.
Two callers on the line. They're going to guess how many times he's going to slap himself around the face with the fish. And then, bungalow heads, you can...
Fish.
What?
Phone. Get the phone. Where is the... Get the... Right, that'll do.
Hello? Yasmin?
Yasmin Wall.
Yasmin!
Yasmin, are you there?
Speak to us.
Speak to us, Yasmin.
Right, forget it then.
I'll try another one. Hello, Stephanie.
Stephanie Bonnick.
We just got a load of prank callers in there, haven't we?
Yeah, just having, mate, having us a laugh.
They're all just taking the fish.
Stephanie Bonnick. Stephanie, Yasmin. Let's try our backup caller, Katie. Katie.
Hello.
Hey,
who's that?
Is that Yasmin, Stephanie, or Katie?
Katie.
Katie, you're our backup caller.
And well done, you might have to play twice.
Nice to hear your voice,
Katie. You might have to be two callers.
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Do you like being the backup caller?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right then. Katie, how many times do you think he's going to slap himself around the face with the fish?
30.
Okay, I'll leave it to you now, mate. See what
you can
do with the phone.
Thank you very much.
Stay there, Katie.
I think it must be because I'm talking to a fish instead, so I'm going to actually take a telephone and actually see if it works with a proper telephone.
What a good idea.
Hello? Yasmin?
Hello?
Yes! Where did you go? Were you having a wee or making a cup of tea? Where did you go? Did you go to Mars?
Hello?
What?
Where?
I've been to the toilet.
You went to the toilet.
Silly Yasmin.
All
right, then. Well, we appreciate that. How many times?
100.
What?
100.
She's going for a big score.
Optimistic.
If you're right, you could win that, a bag of frozen peas. Right then, okay, Yasmin has chosen 100, Katie has chosen 30. Bungalow heads, if you choose the right team, you get 20 Bungalow points. Choose your teams now!
130.
Go! I am 30, he's 100. I'm 30, he's 100.
I'm 100. Well, I'm not 100, I'm actually 26. But come on.
Everybody's gone for 30. Everybody's gone for 30. So let's find out how many times he's going to slip himself round the face with the cod.
Go!
No, look at him go. I don't think it's going to be 30 somehow, folks. Should have gone with me, shouldn't you?
He's got
yes!
A bit.
Yes!
Katie and all you bungalow heads think you picked a bit wrong, didn't you? Katie, you only picked 30. It was 97. Do you know what you get for picking 30? Katie, I think she's had enough already. She's gone.
There she is.
You get diddly squit, Katie.
Diddly squit. Diddly squit. Diddly.
Squit.
You've been told by Raja.
Yasmin! Yasmin! Yasmin?
Yeah?
We won! Yeah! Well done! That's because we got 97. Woo! Come on, Chuck's it here. Chuck's it here. Woo! You win a bag of frozen peas.
Yeah!
Are you happy?
Yeah!
See ya!
More Cod's Wallop tomorrow on the CBBC channel. Come on over here, bugler head. You can take those chips off your
wallet. In a minute.
What?
By the way, I'll find this new stuff over here. Find this new stuff over here.
What is it?
And it says anti-age reduces wrinkles fast.
Are you thinking,
so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a load of... And it makes you look really younger, much younger than you actually are. So I'm just going to...
Oh, go on, get the ball, you idiot! What are you doing, man? Just get stuck in there! Oh, referee, you must be joking! Are you blind or something? Oh, what's he doing over there? You idiot linesman! You need your eyes tested, mate! Whose side are you on? Oh, this is ridiculous!
Lovey.
What, Lovey? What? Oh, you stupid referee!
Lovey! Do you think it might be a good idea if we just turn the television on? Yes, that might be a good idea, Lovey. Oh, Lovey, it's our favourite Diddy Dale.
Wow, that's amazing. I feel about 15 years younger. Hang on, where's Khalid?
He thinks it's going to make him look younger. I mean, that's unbelievable. So it's going to make him look younger. Dom?
Wow, that's amazing. I feel about 15 years younger.
You've already said that line, kid. Do you want to say it again? You got anything else?
Where's Callie?
Where's Callie? I don't know.
What stands in New York and sneezes all day? The Atu of Liberty.
You're very good. You were very good indeed. Well done. I'm going to stick you in here for a bit, though, yeah? Get in there. Go on. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Sorry about that slight interruption, ladies and gentlemen.
The doors have got to shut or the gag won't work! Close that door! Right, thank you. Right, where were we? Who's in the toilet? Wait, come on out! Oh, now what? Hold on a minute.
What do you mean, what do you mean I did very well?
There you are!
Thank you very much. Do you like that gag? It was absolutely laboured to the end.
And
thank you.
For that, Khaled has something for you, don't
what?
You, Khaled?
Oi, come in, Khaled. Just because you're bigger than me, no need to beat me up.
Would anybody like to play another game?
Yeah!
Let's do it.
Hello, Mrs. Smith. Is the housework getting you down? Well, have a look at these.
A range of devices to help you spring clean. With effortless ease, they'll make your home clean. A man-made miracle of modern sciences. A Bungalow head, household appliances. Smith can span in a twinkle.
Oh, look at the mess!
Look at the mess!
Look what happened!
Leaves all over the bungalow. That's why we like to turn our bungalow heads into bungalow head household appliances. And today, they are rakes, Rajar and Ramandeep. And the winner of this will get 150 bungalow points. What you've got to do is we're going to turn you upside down and we're going to rake the floor with you. If it's the tidiest, after 45 seconds, you get the points!
And how many points?
I said 150.
900. No, you want 900!
Oh, tough, you can't have that. 150 is too much.
Right then.
All right, then. Lean forward.
I hope you're light, kid.
Oh,
right, you got 45 seconds starting.
Straight.
Now! Ah, you're heavy. You're the heaviest one I've had. Ah, man! Pull it backwards. Put your head down and pull backwards.
Come on. Break.
Come on, Raja. Get your back into it, mate. I am. Get your head down on the floor.
You can do it.
You can't do it with your hands.
Yes!
Make a big pile! Come on, make a pile!
Ready?
And
break! Good lad!
Come on, Raja!
Break it!
Raja, yeah. How much do you weigh, mate? Right, Dom, that's our weekly exercise routine over.
Unanimous.
Rajar and Ramandeep, it could be unanimous. But let's find out. Please welcome back Dom's mummy.
Oh, stop it. Oh, stop cheating.
Dom's mummy. Here she is.
Stop it. No, keep back in it.
Dom's mummy, everyone.
Hey,
kiss your mummy.
How are you?
Tuck your shirt in.
Hang on a minute.
Tuck your shirt in.
Tuck my shirt in. I'm just going to give my mummy a nice kiss.
Now then, Dom's mummy. Two teams, Ramandeep and Dom, or me and Raja. What do you think of Ramandeep and Dom?
I think Ramandeep and Dom, yes.
Ramandeep and Dom, do you? Right,
Ramandeep and Dom.
And what about Raja and Dick?
Raja and Dick, not very good at all.
No, so who's won?
Ramandeep and Dom.
Ramandeep and Dom, 150 bungalow points.
Thanks, mummy. Now go get your marigolds on and go. Shut a shirt.
Sorry, Raja.
Hi.
It's called a diet, mate.
Busy, where is it? And it is. And I need to win it. What is it? That's all we got time for this week. Join me next week when my guests will include Billy Connolly. Good night.
Oh, genius.
A classic.
I tell you what, I think it should be a new show. Ramandeep and Dom in a Bungalow.
Ramandeep and Dom in a Bungalow.
It sounds better than Dick and Dom in a Bungalow.
Get out of it.
What do you think, Ramandeep? Should we have a new show? Should we sack him? We'll have a show called Ramandeep and Dom in a Bungalow.
Hey. Come on, then you help. I'll go for a bit. You do it.
All right, then, come on. Let's
Ramandeep and Dom in the bungalow.
Let's present the show. Let's have a look at the score. Say, let's have a look at the bungalow head's bungalow scores. Go on, say it. Let's have a look at it. I think Dick's better. Dick, come back quick. He's rubbish.
For some reason, Roger will join me out here. Right then, let's have a look at what the bungalow scores look like at the moment on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. Welcome back to Dick and Dom in the Bungalow.
Welcome back to Dick and Dom in the Bungalow.
Rajar has only got 18. Come
okay,
on, Rajar.
We got Dilbeer with 48.
Daniela with 18 too.
Okay, now if we turn the page, then we got Ramandeep with 183. Very good.
Khalid's got 18.
But in the lead so far, it's...
Yo,
Look at her.
Nice.
Well done, Tanya. How do you feel?
Great.
Great.
Oh, the phone. I don't know. I'll find out.
Hello, Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. Dick speaking. How may I help you?
Dick, ground food around the bungalow like a lion.
Yes, boss. Walk around like a lion.
I don't know whether you noticed this, but that's a bungalow head missing. Where's Daniela? Where is Daniela? Daniela's disappeared. She's not going to be here in the bungalow. I don't know where she's gone. Okay. But never mind. Anyway, look, we don't need Daniela. What are you doing? Right, let's just watch a cartoon properly. It's got a bit weird. All right, let's throw some meat. Never mind, blew up with no smoke again. How about that? Oh no, I know. Look, the videotape. The videotape's too hot. We've got to wait for it to cool down. In the meantime, let's have a look at what's coming up on the Digging on the Bungalow. Here's what's coming up. You can see Do Not Laugh or You Will Lose. Yes, that will be coming your way. Another 2 shakes of lambs, don't bother that. You've got Tricky Training. Who will be the master magician this week? Stay tuned to find out. We've got some Looney Tunes. We've also got the game that is quite literally sweeping the nations. It's Bogey. Yes, and also we got Creamy Mark. Mark, stay tuned.
Mandingo. Shut up! Morning, I'm Inspector Mutton Chops. And I've just had a note in from one of my constables. Rajar says, you are an idiot. Thank you very much, Rajar. Yes, my name is Inspector Mutton Chops, and reports this week seem to suggest that insanity is spreading in Britain. Let's have a look at the evidence.
The search for Britain's maddest town continues. And today, I'm here in Reading with my friend, Nigel Wackwick, who's single and lonely. And I'm here to find out how many people are mad enough to say, Nigel, will you marry me? How do you feel about that?
Oh, I'm so excited!
Are you mad?
Raving mad.
Yes. Would you get down on one knee and propose to Nigel Wackwick?
Propose?
Yeah, propose to Nigel Wackwick.
Nigel, please. I love you dearly. Will you please marry me?
Yes,
please,
yes, man. Yes, he's done it. He's done it. He's done it.
Please.
Man.
Oh, Nigel, whatever your name is. Please marry
me. Nigel Wackwick. Nigel Wackwick.
Will you marry me? Will you marry me? We don't have a ring.
You don't need one.
Nigel here is sad and lonely. He's single for very many years. Would you get down on your knee and propose to him?
Him?
Yes.
If you had a female, though, maybe something could go on, but him?
You know, it is a female.
Called Nigel. Female called Nigel.
Yeah.
Please, would you get down on one knee?
I'd get down on one knee.
Yeah,
in
please.
Town centre on broad daylight and propose to a doll.
I love you.
Am I really going to do this?
Yeah.
Am I really going to do this?
Yeah. Oh, love in the air.
All right, Nigel,
yeah? Yeah.
I know you're feeling kind of lonely, yeah?
Yeah.
I've been watching you for a while.
Yeah.
I like your style.
Yeah.
Yo, you want to be my wife?
Yes!
Oh, come on, come on. No, man, that's wrong.
Oh, no, I'm your wife!
Are you mad?
Probably.
Will you get down on one knee and propose to Nigel Wackwick?
No, certainly not. I've got one husband. He's more than enough. Thank you.
Does he look like this?
Worse.
I bet he does look worse. Oh, charming. There you go.
The smell of the sausages is making love fly in the air.
Just say, Nigel, will you marry me?
At least give us a sausage.
Nigel, will you marry me?
Oh, yeah, baby! Yeah!
Are you mad?
I am mad.
Get down on one knee and propose to Nigel Wackwick.
Awesome.
Magic.
Will you marry me?
No!
Oh, beautiful. Give him a kiss.
It's fine.
Give him a kiss.
He just denied me.
Please!
I'm sorry, I'm heartbroken.
I changed my mind!
I'm heartbroken.
I love you!
Nigel, will you marry me?
Not me, to him. I'm not Nigel, are you?
Where the voice is coming from you?
No, it's not!
Daddy, but okay.
Right?
Hey?
Right? Maybe?
Yeah, oh, he's getting excited. Was that? Did you just say, will you marry me?
Yes,
did
I you? Asked him if you wanted to marry.
And let's just. Yes, he's accepted.
Yes,
okay. He can't. No, he can't.
He would need to get his hair cut.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Nigel, will you marry me?
Yeah. Oh, give him a kiss, it's lovely. Oh, thank you very much. Oh, look at that. Oh, Nigel. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Would you get down on one knee and ask Nigel Wackwit if you will marry him? He's very lonely. He's been out of a job and out of a wife for about a year now. He's very lonely and cries most nights to sleep. Would you marry him?
I wouldn't marry him, no.
Please. Right
on.
You're just my type.
Oh,
I shall prefer the bearded man myself.
Right. Step on, and the bearded man certainly won't marry you.
So, there we have it. 8 out of 10 people here in Reading were mad enough to propose to Nigel Wackwit. He's now got that many potential wives, he has to go home and have a really good think about it.
Oh, yeah! I must go put on my lippy! Oh, mwah,
mwah. I suppose you think it's funny, don't you, putting a flashing light on top of your head, Mandinga? Water. Oh, another note in from my constable here. It says, shut up and get on with it. Now then, some people might not realise the seriousness of this case, but there was another case back in 1979 when Britain was plagued with people proposing to dummies, which put a lot of pressure on the British police force. What are you doing in my chair? That's my chair, son. Look at this lot. They're all right lazy lowabouts, aren't they?
Hello?
Right yeah. then, you lot. Right. As yeah. we can see from the footage, a very serious problem is happening down there in Reading. So now then, citizens, if you should see such behaviour on the streets in your neighbourhood, here are 3 steps to apprehend the lunatic. Step one, please. Tempt them away with a cake on a stick.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Step two, get to a place of safety and radio for Scooby-Doo. Go, Scooby, go, go, go! Step three, Scooby-Doo to escort Nigel off the premises.
Gone.
And that's it.
Quick, Bungalow, come here, quick, 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 go, go, go!
Get out there and fright crime!
Yeah!
Right, right, everyone sit down, sit down, sit down. Don't fight crime. You can't be bothered to do that. One thing we are going to do is watch the second part of Avon of the Yukon. Look, there it is. It's cooled down. It's cooled as a cucumber. And now here it is. Look, 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 look. 1, 2, 3. Oh, there it is. Shut up, it's Dick and Dom in the Bungalow here on a Saturday morning with Dick, Dom and the Bungalow Head, who are invisible. And here are their scores, which are visible. Here we go, have a look at the Bungalow Head score for the Bungalow Point. Here we go.
Roger's got 18.
OK, we've got Dilbeer with 48.
Daniela with 18.
Who's going to win at the end of the day? Could it be Randy with 183?
I don't think Khaled has only got 18.
It most possibly might be Tanya with 188. Stay tuned to find out.
And now more points be won in another game. It's Do Not Laugh or you will lose. Yes. Do Not Laugh or you will lose. 2 teams of 2. We need 2 players for this game, so we're going to have a bit of a huddle and find out who's playing it. Okay,
okay? So let's have a huddle. Who's going to be? Who
doesn't laugh? Who's going to be?
Okay, I've got it.
Who's
it?
Wait.
No, you're going to play. Okay, right. You two over here.
Lovely. Okay, then it's Dilbert against Tanya. This is Do Not Laugh or you will lose. Basically, a staring out competition. And remember, you're playing for your whole team here. And if you win, you'll get 100 bungalow points.
I just spat
at you. Sorry.
It's not very nice, is it?
It's not very nice at all.
There's plenty more where that came from.
There's 3 golden rules during this game. The first golden rule. Why are you moving your head back like that? Is my breath sting?
It does, doesn't it? It does. Yeah. Does I've got to clarify this. His breath pongs, doesn't it?
Dog's bum. Thanks very much.
Yeah?
Thank you, Dave.
Like a mouse's mouth.
First golden rule is put your hands behind your backs and keep them there at all times.
The second...
Do you know the rules, Raja?
Do you know the rules? What's the second golden rule?
Keep your eyes at each other at all times. And the third rule is that do not laugh or you will lose.
Yes! Yes! He licked our job!
Go! Go. Well done, Raja.
Look at them. Staring into the abyss. First of all, here to see if we can laugh are the silly noises. No touching. No touching.
Hands behind your backs.
Oops, sorry. That was smart like his okay, breath.
They're doing well. Should we get a caller on the line?
Let's get a caller.
Let's get a caller. Hello. Who's there?
Hello.
Hello, who are you?
I'm Aiden.
Aiden? Hello, Aiden. You got something funny to tell him?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Why did the teacher wear sunglasses?
I don't know. Why did the teacher wear sunglasses?
Because the class was so bright.
Because the class was so bright.
Right, look at each other. You've got to keep looking at each other.
Look at each other.
All right, next caller.
Thank you, Aiden. You get a digital camera. No, it's not mine.
No, he doesn't get anything. He didn't make them laugh.
Oh, he didn't make them laugh.
Here. Still fucking kick you in the butt. Hello?
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 Who's that?
It's Alex.
How old are you?
I'm 11.
You're about 18, aren't you? Come on, what's your joke? What are you going to do to make them laugh?
No!
Thanks.
Thanks, fine. You get a t-shirt for that, nice one.
Okay.
Oh, look, stand back.
Tommy Cooper.
It's Tommy Cooper.
I was in the hospital the other day. I said, I've broken my arm in 3 places. He said, don't go back to those places then.
Yeah.
Oh, all right then, please yourself. I've got the best wife in England. The other one's in Australia. You gotta love that.
Thank you very much, Tommy.
Yeah. Oh, all right, thank you, Tommy.
Thank you, Tommy. Thank you very much. Right. Can you stop walking around in front of the shot? Please.
We can't see them.
Okay, right, let's bring
it. Oh, no,
oh, look.
Stand back. Look. It's a leprechaun.
Come on, Mario, please.
It's like Lionel Kicking.
Let me give you some of that. Let me give you some of that. What's a dance now? What's a vogel? Oh, you like the vogel?
Oh, he's going a bit. He likes the leprechaun.
Oh,
no way. Last chance.
Nope,
last chance.
Hasn't done it.
Right, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, leprechaun.
Do you know what?
Push off.
We've got another. Okay, come on, freshen up. Look at each other. Do not laugh. Let's bring on the next. Oh, look.
Here
comes
else.
Trumpelstiltskin.
Trumpelstiltskin.
No, wait.
Roger!
Wait.
Gilbert.
Do your bit.
I was going for it.
Look. What?
He's going.
No. Wait. Has he?
No, he nearly did.
He nearly.
Back to it again.
He nearly did.
Is he going to be able to keep himself composed?
One more smirk, and you've had it, Dill Beer.
There's it!
There you go, thank you very much. I'll tell you what, we need to rename this game. Do not smirk or you will lose. He didn't laugh at all, did he?
Who was on Dom's team?
It was Tanya, it was Ramadeep, and also Daniela.
100 Bungalow points each.
100 Bungalow points each.
What's that?
Let's be together.
What?
No,
we ain't got any more time to play. We can all laugh now.
Yeah.
More do not laugh, or you will lose next Saturday. Yeah. I'm Nick and Dom in the bungalow.
Go!
Smirk. Do not smirk, or you will lose.
Yes, I know. Do not smirk. We really should light up, and they have to laugh.
Enjoying yourself, aren't you, Raja?
Yeah.
Look who's here. Do you want to go and see the cat?
This guy's having a good time.
Yeah, look, he's having a good time.
Wait a minute. No, stop it!
Hey, I haven't said nothing. Hey, come on, mate.
Sorry, pussycat. Sorry, Raja's had too much sugar on his cornflakes
this
morning.
That's okay. Don't worry, Raja.
What are you doing? Don't poke him in the eyes. Stop it! He's the poor cat. Listen to what he has to say. What are you doing to him?
No, Raja. Stop, Raja.
What?
Raja, stop it.
No more caffeine.
Naughty Raja.
Oh, no, stop it. Poor cat. Only I'm allowed to...
Okay, Cap,
what have you got to say?
No, please.
What have you got to say?
Well,
put it up. Yeah, stop it. Where have you been?
RSPCA.
Look at me.
RSPCA. Move.
Just leave it, Cap. Stop hitting him in the head. Go and stand over there. Stop it.
I want to break free. Bye.
sorry. Listen, I'm really sorry. I'm really sorry. Are you all right? Where have
I'll
you
be
been?
Back.
Now, where have you been?
Oh, I've been to Macclesfield, Cheltenham, and Penge because you know, Dom, I get around.
I get around.
I'm a real cool head. I make some real good bread. Bug driving up and down the where the kids are hip.
Wait!
Oh, my face! Oh.
And I'll put the lock on, so Randy can't chase after him.
The Bungalow heads are here too, and Bungalow points, their Bungalow points mean prizes. These are the prizes they can win on this weekend's Dick and Dom in a Bungalow. Third prize is that.
That.
Look nice on your half.
No, no, on your where?
On your half.
Thank you, pardon. Same to you. All right, then, now we've got a second prize. Second prize is this. It's a DVD, colour TV, combi with DVDs, and a remote control.
First prize as well, first prize. Who wants the pss two?
Everyone wants.
Look at it.
Games console and game. And also, if you're the winner of today's Bungalow, Saturday morning at 11 o'clock, if you're the winner today, you'll get that bonus prize. Isn't it nice? Lovely.
Who wants the bonus prize?
Me!
We're back tomorrow morning on the CBBC Channel 2 from 9 o'clock. Let's have a look at the Bungalow Heads Bungalow School, see who's getting those prizes at the moment.
And also see who might be doing the pants dance as well. Have a look.
Rajar's got 18.
I think it could be Rajar. Dilbeer's got 48.
Daniela with 118.
Ramadeep's got 283.
Khalid, 18.
Okay, I think it could be Khalid and Roger. But Tanya's at the lead with 288.
Tanya, you're still in the lead, my dear. You're still in the lead. She's happy.
Roger and Khalid. Come over here, Khalid and Roger.
Roger's already got himself sorted out.
I can't wait. No, what are you doing? Oh, man. What's he going to do with...
What are you going to do with that now?
What are you
going
to do
with that?
Hey.
Now he's...
What? What? You can't work it, can you? Get off! No, stop it!
Right, right then, you two! Because you two are in last place at the moment in a bungalow, you have to do the pants dance. Go! That's Daniela's dad.
Daniela,
that's your dad.
Look, that's your dad. Go on. What are you? Stroke the bunny rabbit. Oh, everyone, get the bunny. Go on, get the bunny.
Keep sending in your pants dance letters. We've had one here from the Sydney McCarthy. Oh, there's dear Dick and Dorm. Pants are a good present for my aunts, and I've put my aunt's present of the pants on my head. Who's that with you? Maybe your dad. Thank you, Sydney.
Okay, this is hello, Dick and Dom. Here's a picture of me watching Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. I love your show, so I watch your show every week. I can. From Tim Exley from Cornwall.
Well done, you get the world's largest pants. If you've got a picture of you in the pants doing the dance, then send them into this dress. Pants Dance, Dick and Dom, the Bungalow, PO Box 38894, London, W12 6X.
Hey! I think we might have to do a moment where we just go outside.
We've got emails.
We just go outside and leave for a bit.
They're calming.
Oh, they're calming?
They're fine, they're calm.
Yeah.
Right. Keep emailing, bungalow@bbc.co.uk. Perry writes, says, hi, Dick and Dom, my mum thinks you are pants, but I think you're really good. The food she gives me is like creamy muck-muck, so what does she know? Lovely, thank you very much, Perry. You get one of them,
This is from Daniela, who's 14 years old. Hi, Dick and Dom, I have a little secret to tell you. Ever since Dom has been on telly, I can't help but gaze at him all the time. With Dick, it is much a different matter. He's ugly, and I don't fancy him at all.
Yeah, lovely.
Lovely.
Thanks very much.
Thank you very much. And I couldn't agree with you more.
There's
a prize for you. What about Dick Fancy? Dick Fancy, Melody.
Bungalow at bbc.co.uk. We've got three more of those prizes to give away. Please, send them in. Where's Dilbert gone?
Dilbert? Oh, no. Oh, hey.
We
come to the toilet.
Over. Is he in there?
He is.
Get back in there, Deborah.
Sorry, everyone.
Ah, Dilbert, take a pew. What did the puppy say when it sat on the sandpaper?
I don't know.
Ruff, ruff. You like that?
Tell you what,
there's only one way to get Dilbert out the toilet. We're going to have to form a line.
Everyone get behind us in a line.
Do a bit of a silly walk this way.
Okay, Dilbert, come out the toilet.
And hopefully Dilbert will join onto the end.
Ready,
of it.
Ready? Go.
Thank you, Dick and Dom. Today we're at the London Bogey Show to play bogey.
No, we're not. We're here at the London Boat Show to play boats.
No, we're not. We're at the London Boat Show to play bogeys.
Yeah, the rules of the game, as always, are very, very simple. All we have to do is take it in turns to say the word bogeys, starting off quiet, then getting louder and louder and louder until one of us bottles out, until one of us isn't as loud as the other.
There's the bogeyometer. It's just sailed in to find out who's shouting it the loudest. So without further ado, let's play boats.
No, bogeys.
Bogeys. Yeah.
So, plenty of nautical naughtiness promised this morning.
Bogies.
And McCourt gets us off to a flying start with a 3.5 on the snotometer. Yachts of action promised here at the International Boat Show as McCourt tests the quality of the timber. And Wood.
Bogies.
Responds with a 4.6. Comfortable margin. Would, of course, needing to claw a game back as the competition stands at Richard McCourt 10, Dominic
Bogies.
Wood 7. There's McCourt in with a 4.8, which is just enough to keep him in this game.
Big.
Bogies!
Big bogey. That's a 5.2, taking us over the halfway mark.
Oops.
Very nice. Boat.
Stormy waters ahead for McCourt.
Bogies!
It's a fine bogey. It's a 5.7.
Okay.
Wood determined not to wave goodbye to this one.
Bogies!
It's a good bogey. It's a 6.0. Very cleverly played as the crowd stands in awe. Or by an awe. What's McCourt got?
Bogies!
He's got a beauty. It's a 7.5.
Bogies!
No hesitation from Wood. 7.6, only just keeping him in the game. That's a fine result for Wood.
I've got so much inside me today.
But McCourt.
Oh, shuffle that.
Fighting talk.
It's a pretty good one, isn't it? It's a pretty good one.
And that was a pretty good one. That's an 8.4.
You've got to pelt it out now.
He certainly has. That was a stroppy bogey for this
bogey
game. That's a 9.0. And the customers and staff are not quite sure where this could be leading us.
Ahoy.
Nice little bit of tomfoolery there from McCourt. But the important issue.
Bogey!
Can he beat 9.0? Yes, he can. There's a 9.3. Really belting up the bogey scale.
Bogey!
9.3 to beat. He's done
bogey!
It. It's a 9.5. But McCourt straight back in with a 9.6. Pipping him at the post. Can he come back?
Oh, you chicken.
No, he can't.
Bogey!
There's the winning bogey. Richard McCourt, 11. Dominic Wood, 7. So, as the grand final looms, McCourt
bogey!
Extends his lead. Who is this man?
I caught the show last week. I laughed so much, tears welled up in my eyes. I cracked 4 ribs, split my trousers, rolled around on the carpet, and my wig fell off. No, only joking. I don't wear a wig.
That would like to play bogeys with one of us two.
Yeah.
Bogeys! Have you got one, Roger, that wants to play it, yeah? Or you just put your hand up in the air? Just put your hand up in there. Right, if you got one that wants to play with us, then send your details to this address, which is Bogey.
Oh,
Thank you. Easy as that.
All right.
Why are you dressed as a spaceman?
Because we're now about to take Tanya.
Are you?
To do a space-aged tricky training. Put on your helmet and walk this way. Walk this way.
The game I wanted to play, Creepy Muck Muck.
Come through here. You're the current leader. And now, you must come through to the room of tinfoil and space. Go and sit down. Here we are in the space laboratory. And I'm going to teach you how to do a trick. You're going to perform this trick for all of your mates. If they guess how the trick is done, then you go from first place to fourth place. And also, you have to spend the whole afternoon hiding under a rug. Yes, you'll be just brushed completely under the carpet. Why don't you go and sit over there? Let me just move the chair over here. Sit there. All right? So here's the trick. I'll teach it to you in a minute. Let's go and see what happens. Now, a lot of people think that the moon is made from cheese. Do you think the moon is made from cheese? Watch. Let's try and do some magic from space.
It's one small
magic trick
for man, one giant
massive illusion
for mankind.
And again.
It's one small
magic trick
for man,
massive illusion.
Amazing trick, do you think? Do you know how the trick is done, oh Space One? No. Well, I'll now tell you. This is a cross between a trick and a gag that's revealed by a lot of comedians. Hopefully, your fellow bungleheads aren't comedians that know gags. This is how the trick is done. Here we go. Oh no! It's on a stick! All right then, here's how the trick's done. You get a polystyrene ball, you can get these from model shops, right? Paint it to look like a moon. Then you get a coat hanger, you just whack it in there, all right? And then you hold on to the coat hanger with your hand, right? Then you get a cloth, you can use a tea towel if you've got one at home, right? And you, careful with tea towels, very dangerous. And then what you do is you hold it, comme ci, comme ça. You see, like that? So you're holding the special coat hanger behind it, hold this straight, and then just simply push the moon into the cloth. See that? You just push it in, like that. From the back it looks pretty crud, but from the front, it looks magic. There you go.
It's one small
magic trick
for man.
All right. And then what you do to finish it all off, you just make it appear just at the top like that, and then you're done. That's your magic trick. Do you think you can do it? All right then. Do you want to give it a go? You wear your helmet, because you're a space woman. There you go. Good. Now hold the other end of this hand between your fingers. Now turn around and face everyone at home. Push it into the cloth. Magic, magic, all magic. Yes, I think you need to practice, don't you? All right, then you stay there and practice, and I'm going to go and have some fun. Woo! See you later. Bye-bye. Whoops.
Is that what you think, that you're coming in here to have some fun, are you?
What?
Hmm? You said you're coming back through to here to have some fun.
Well, yeah, I do.
Who's trying to get into the bungalow now? Right, hold on a minute, let's hold it. Hello, Dick and Dom in the bungalow. This is Dick. Who's there?
We're the three wise David Siemens.
I'm David.
I'm David.
And I'm David. Can we come in?
We're not doing much, so...
No!
Yeah, go on then, we're not doing much at the moment. You can come in, come on.
And
you
they're
come.
Not doing much.
Hello, three David Siemens. Hello. Yes, you see, the David Siemens have got plenty of time on their hands at the moment, haven't they? Yeah, because they've got no job anymore.
Yeah.
But sorry about that, David. And basically, this is three wise David Siemens. They have questions for each of you bungalow heads. If you answer the question correctly, you'll get 50 bungalow points. If you answer the question wrongly, we'll take 50 bungalow points away from you. Andrew Crow, a David Seaman ponytail, and Tash.
Oh, what do you think of that, David?
How's the back? Daniela, come over here. You're first. Stand on that spot, pick a number out of the football and read it to them.
Five.
Number five.
Hi. What is the longest river in the world?
The River Thames.
The Thames, that's incorrect.
Incorrect! Oh, Daniel, you lost 51 points. And you're going to get a tash. And a David Seaman from the Italian.
Yes. You're going to stay like that for the rest of the show.
Look, there it is. Hello, David.
She's really enjoying herself today, isn't she?
Isn't she?
Well, Daniel.
The longest river in the world, incidentally, is Nile.
Oh, Nile, right.
Four.
Thank you.
Four.
Dilba has chosen four.
What's heavier, a ton of bricks or a ton of feathers?
Can you repeat that?
What's heavier, a ton of bricks or a ton of feathers?
A ton of bricks.
Oh. Incorrect.
Incorrect. The answer was feathers.
No, it's not. They're both the same. They both weigh a ton. It's a trick question, Nicky.
All right. All right.
Here, can I just say, Rich actually suddenly said, in all his knowledge, no, it's not. The ton of feathers is heavier than a ton of bricks.
Dilba, you've lost 50 Bungalow points and you're now David Seaman. Ramandeep, come up here and pick a number.
Ramandeep.
What's the number, Ravendy?
Number one. Be nice.
Number one. Hi, that's me. Name all four members of the Beatles.
I don't mean cockroach and dung beetle. You know the pop band.
The Beatles. They were big.
They released a couple of singles. I think they got to number 15 in the charts.
They weren't that big, really.
You know, I think Simon Cowell was their manager.
Was it Simon Cowell was their manager?
No.
You're
going to
give me 5 seconds, right?
You don't know.
No, he doesn't know. Oh,
yeah, stay there.
The correct answer is Paul, George, Ringo, and John Hyde.
You've lost 50 Bungalow points, Ravendeep, and you're now David Seaman.
They're all David Seaman so far, but what about Raja?
Oh, no.
Raja, come on over. Pick a number, my friend. My crazy little friend.
Number two.
Question two.
Number two.
Oh, number two. What nationality is the dish moussaka?
Spanish.
No, that's incorrect. Oh. It's Greek.
It's Greek! Oh. 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 It's lost 50
points. I didn't say that. No, don't accept it.
David! Seaman! There he is, Roger. It quite suits you, actually, mate. And finally, Khalid, come up here and pick a number. Can you save face for the team?
Number three.
Number three. Come on, let's try.
What are the small workers called in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory?
The little workers in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. They got orange faces and green hair. What do they call them? You don't know?
Sure. All right, what was the answer?
It's Uncle Lumpus.
Our Bungalow heads are David Seaman. David, thank you very much. Nice cup of tea for you there. We broke the law for you.
Go stand by the breakfast bar.
Enjoy it.
Have a nice cup of tea. Your moustache has gone off? Or when was it sell-by date?
It was yesterday.
What?
Yesterday?
Oh, you're right.
Where are you off to, Raja?
Where are you off to? What's he doing? What are you doing? He keeps just wandering around in a daze. What's he doing?
Hello.
Raja, come back because it's cartoon time.
Cartoon time. All right then. What are we
going to
watch?
Looney Tunes.
Looney Tunes.
5 minutes of Looney Tunes.
Who wants to watch 5 minutes of Looney Tunes? Then we'll have some more games. Yeah. Oh, great.
Are you fed up? I'll see you in five.
Roll up, Dom's tricky training has been done. Gather round your skeptics, the magic moment's come. Now is the time to suspend your disbelief. Will it be the wilderness or will it be relief?
Yes, it's a Bungalow spaceship. Will it be bewilderment? Will it be belief? Tanya here has learned how to do a magic trick. She's going to perform it for all of you guys. She's in first place at the moment. If any of you guys guess how the magic trick is done, she's going to go from first place into fourth place and end up having to hide under a carpet for the rest of the afternoon. And you guys get 10 Bungalow points each if she gets the trick right. And none of you guess how the trick's done, she stays in first place. Ready? Does everyone understand? Say yes, Paul.
Yes.
Paul, what? Shut up, we're tough. All right then, ready? 3, 2, 1. Tanya, the magician.
Some people think that the moon is made from cheese.
She's good.
She is good, isn't she? Oh! Right, now put the whole lot down behind there, and everyone has to try and get. No, it's down there. Oh, yes, look.
Right, Raja's back. Go on, Raja.
Yes, easy, because you get this little stick here, and then you put the stuff in, you poke it into it, and then she, in her other hand, she showed both hands, and one, and it was behind there. She put it back down, and she got it, and then she got it out, and then she put it back down, and then she went down.
What?
I think I kind of get what you were coming from.
I think he got it right.
Actually, so basically, you're saying there's a stick with the ball on the end and it's behind the sheet. Yeah, and she's, yeah. Yeah. Right, there you are.
Well, there we go. Even if he didn't get it right, he has now, because you told him. Well, that's just charming, isn't it? She hasn't done a flipping chance now, does she? Poor girl, look at her. She's sweating over that magic trick for about 10 minutes.
Hold on, Dilbert thinks he's got a different solution to it.
I think when she was pointing it out on the...
No, there's no point. No, there's no point. Right, Raja got it right.
No one get...
What?
Raja, he got it wrong.
He got it right. No, he said no. There was a stick with a ball on the end.
I know,
and there was a stick with a ball on the end.
Stick. What? It's not a stick. A stick.
Right, get it. Go through there and go and hide under a carpet. Go on, go through the windows. Yeah. Through the windows.
Nice one, Raja. Come on, let's go back to the bungalow. Let's go back to the bungalow.
Let's go and have a nice cup of tea.
Let's have a nice cup of tea and think about it. Hey!
How many points do we get?
Hold on.
Hang on a minute.
Hold on. Here, come on in. Hold on.
What is it?
I'm picking up a message.
Are you? That's nice.
I'm picking up a signal.
That's good.
So help me, Obi Dom Kadiki. You're our only hope. And now, the rebel butt dance.
What can that mean? What can it mean?
What could it mean, bungalow heads? We've had a sign. Well, let's have a...
Take two of your best men and guard the archway. Soon this battle bungalow will be fully operational. No one will stop us this time.
Darth Vader is in the bungalow with loads of stormtroopers.
Wait.
Have another look.
I feel a disturbance in the Force I've not felt since the Battle of Yavin Splat.
You know what's happened?
What?
Yeah.
They're trying to turn the bungalow into the Death Star. No! Will you all just shut up and act on a little bit? Please, put the pies down and just go with it. No, pies down, please. Put the pies down, kids. Thanks.
You tell him.
Right, out. You're not joining in. Get out. You've ruined it all. Get out.
Right, what were you trying to say, Dom?
Right. You know what's happened, don't you?
You came off you.
They've turned the... What?
No!
We've got to end up, go through Tatooine and end up in the Dagobah system.
The Dagobah system?
Yes. We may be the size of Jawas and Ewoks, but we must plow on like an Atat warrior. Couldn't guess us a Star Wars dude, could you? We're gonna march in there and see Gold Leader and Red Leader from the X-Wing Fighter Squad. We will not lose. We must see the Gamorrean guards. We will take over the Emperor. We will go, 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 go! It's Yoda. Yoda, who do you think should be man of the match? Who is it?
I shall choose Daniela.
Daniela, come over here. Come over here. You are the woman of the match. You're going to get 82 bungalow points.
The Force has been with you, my child. The Force is strong in you. You've got the Bungalow points. Nice one.
Oh, hey.
Great yoga impression,
sorry, Darth. He's creamy old Darth.
Well, at least Darth was better than the pirate. Right then, hello, who's there? Dick and the Bungalow, Dick speaking. Who are you? Hello?
Hello?
Who's there?
Hello?
Anyone on the phone?
It's the Almighty King.
It's the Almighty King! Who are you giving Bungalow points to, Almighty One?
Take 100 off Raja.
You're taking 100 off Raja? Why?
Because he don't listen.
Because he doesn't listen? What a great idea.
Raja, you've just lost 100 points because you don't listen.
Thank you very much, Almighty Kid. Bye.
Brilliant.
And it's the beginning of the end of the show.
It's the beginning of the show. For Saturday morning.
Everyone line up.
Is it going to be Raja or Dilba or Daniela or Ramandeep or Khalid or Tanya? Tanya, Khalid, Ramandeep, Daniela.
It's
or Raja. It's
Raja.
Raja.
Off you go, mate. Off to the toilet. You're going to get a dog.
That's good.
Dressed as David Seaman.
And tomorrow, the Bungalow is back on the CBBC channel, the digital network, at 9 o'clock. And this is what you can expect on there. On the CBBC channel for another Dick and Norman de Bungalow and all of that. Here now, Tanya today lost tricky training. She got banished to be swept under the carpet.
And a quick look, it's a very quick
swept
look.
Under the carpet, there she
and is. And that's about Sweeper as much as you can see.
And she's staying there for the rest of the afternoon. Let's find out who the winner is today on Dick and Norman de Bungalow. It's Ramandeep!
Ramandeep, come over, stand there.
Stand up on the podium, Ramandeep. You are the king of the Bungalow
today.
Right,
over here, if you're over here, Dobby.
And Ramandeep, you get the bonus prize today, covered in creamy muck, 3 CD singles.
Are you happy?
Yeah!
Now we should be ready to give Roger a darn good gunging. Are we all ready?
Yeah.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, gunging! Oh, look at him. What a great big nanny.
Nanny!
He avoided all the guns.
Unbelievable. You had a good time today, Bungalow Eds?
Have you had a good time?
Yeah!
Fantastic, all
tomorrow,
right.
Tomorrow on Dick and Norman de Bungalow, you'll be up for those third prize, which is that. Second prize, which is the DVD combi and DVDs. And first prize, which is the games console and games.
All right, fantastic. Well, that's been it from Dick and Norman de Bungalow. Hope you've enjoyed the show. Don't forget to join us tomorrow at 9 o'clock on the CBBC channel. Who is going to win?
Should we have a dance?
Yeah.
Go on, then.
Oh, fantastic. Right, we'll dance. Thank you very much. Prize leader, come over here. You're ready. Everyone stand
come
up.
Come on, Stormtroopers, on you get. Darth Vader, dancey, dancey.
Come on, Darth, over here, right to the front. Come on, Darth, come on.
Say bye-bye, everyone. Say bye-bye to everyone at home.